I'm going to start to present you collective artists because I'm more collective woman, and it's very difficult to, you know, to speak for myself. And the second presentation, it will be more focused about my project because I'm a filmmaker and also an activist. So why we decided to create this art journal? Because they have an art journal called Revue Noire in the 19th, and I learned African contemporary story about in this journal, because in art school in France they have not we don't learn about African contemporary art. But now that's very funny because I started this year to teach in art school in Quimper, African art contemporary for the young student, because of the market, and also because also we talk about the concept of Africa. It's fashion. In France, last year, there are so many exhibitions about African art. It was more made by a French white curator, and also it was for some French institution. It was also maybe the first time that they exhibit African artists. And when we started this, can you at the same time? Sorry. Yes. Yes. So when we started to do this publication, why? Because there are no African art contemporary publication in France. And also, it was very difficult at this time for the African artists to be showing in the museum, in the gallery, and also to have art space. It was very difficult. And we tried to, how do you say, to this publication, it's kind of also art space, it's a laboratory, because for each exhibition we exhibit the content of the magazine in art space. It's also the, how do you say, we find the way to exhibit this artist that we defend in this publication. And also it was very important also to rethinking the art journal in 21st century, how with a digital magazine you can exist in art space as a magazine, and after in the paper publication. So it was very important to exist in this free format. And so it was also important to rethinking how to theorize art today, and also to test and to experiment the new artistic practice, also how we can reinventing the demonstration, the way to show the other, and also we have no space, and so the publication, when we started, was the only space to do and to defend all these things. And in last year, I think in, we do a performance with the collective, and the idea it was to present and to rethinking the future museum. And we do this performance, and we have a curator from Centre Pompidou who was in the. She was there, and she was very interesting about what we're doing. And the next year, she called me. She sent me an email, and she said, "You know, we have this new space in Centre Pompidou called Galerie Zero, with no money for the production." No, nothing. But she was very interesting that to working with the collective, and also to say it could be a challenge to, how do you say, to how we can occupy the space in Centre Pompidou as a black collective. And the topic of the exhibition was the feature museum. So as a filmmaker, I decided to propose a fictional museum to question the post-colonial study in this space, if it's possible to question the political subject in the Centre Pompidou, how we can, how do you say, bring some new narrative, and also make some invisible story could be existed in this space. Because in the Centre Pompidou, they don't really interested about African art. They don't really interested about the narrative of who question the aesthetic in post-coloniality. So when she invited me, she said, "You know, because we don't have money, you can do what you want in this space." So I decided to select only black artists, and also I know that the piece of art that this kind of artist that I selected, I know that it will be very difficult to enter the collection of Centre Pompidou also. So it was a kind of challenge. And we do this exhibition, it was very, very difficult, because people working in this institution decided to, they had no communication, it was the first time. And also, we must, how do you say, fight with the institution to, how do you say, to be free, and also to have an access for some kind of public who doesn't really come to the Centre Pompidou, because we're working a lot with young people who live in the suburbs of Paris. We are very interested in how we can also exchange and also teach art, and also develop a new practice with this young public, because they don't really they never went to the museum. And this exhibition, we decided to do a publication about the content that we produce in the Centre Pompidou. And this publication, we're thinking like a kind of concept, like a paper museum. And this is some performance with some artists that are inviting to perform in the space of Centre Pompidou. And also the idea is to invite this artist to propose some the way they're rethinking the new museum. And Cheryl Bolden, she came from New York, but she lived in Paris, and she worked a lot with young black people. And she has her own studio, and her own studio also, it's a kind of museum, because she collected many things about slavery, about her own story, and she has a kind of luggage museum, and she has all the things that she collected, she can put it in the luggage. And so it was very interesting to invite her to perform, and to also to create for one day a museum. And we have Olivier Marmeuf. He's a writer, he's a curator, he's also have he's in charge of a space called Chiasma. And Chiasma, it's one of, they have a few spaces in Paris who show and question the post-colonial study. And he perform about French institution and the way, the representation of the black body in the museum. And Dina Duyeb, she's a musician, and she work a lot about traditional music mixed with punk music, and it was a dialogue between her a composition and one of my short movies that I've made in Trinidad, and I spoke about Carnaval. And here we have two artists. It's a collective, a black Brazilian collective. And the idea is to try to tell the story of black Brazilian in art. And here it's a kind of, it's a art video by Chassol. Chassol is a musician, and also it's a do a lot of art video. And this video was really want to show in Centre Pompidou, because it was working about the discourse of Taubira. And this discourse was very controversy in Paris. They have a lot of debate about this. And he rewriting by, I don't know how do you say in English, but not the music. Notes. Each word how do you say? Correspond en fait, Chaque mot, en fait, correspond à une note de musique. Yes. Sorry, I'm tired. And she rewriting all the discourse of Tobira, but with the music, the note of music. And here it's a discussion between two curators. One curator called Simon Jami, and it was the first black curator who do exhibition in Centre Pompidou called Africa Remise, and it was in 10 years ago, and 10 years after, I was invited in the same place to do an exhibition. So I invite him to how do you say, to have an exchange, to if when he do this exhibition 10 years ago, what's happening 10 years after in the same place. And I don't know how you can translate in English, but c'est un jeu de mots en fait. Comment le commissaire revient sur les lieux du crime, you know? Yes. So we have this kind of debate and exchange, and it was very, very interesting. And he said that, you know, every 10 years, African art is in fashion in France, so we must waiting next 10 years if you wants to have a African exhibition in Centre Pompidou. And also the idea is also to how to decolonizing this space. Is it possible to decolonize this space? And we have Françoise Vergès, she's an activist and politologue. She present a fictional museum, but museum has to cure people. And she do very strong performance. She spoke about a project that she doing in Ireland, in La Réunion, because she wants to create a museum. And they have a lot of piece of art. They started to collect the narrative of and also the past story of the family in Île de la Island of Réunion, and also she recording the sound. She asked people to bring our archive, costume, picture, all kind of object who represent the past of the island. And but they didn't find a funding to build the museum. And we have another project, another exchange with Malik Ndiaye, who also is a curator and teacher in Dakar, who is in charge of this museum called Le Musée des Civilisations Noires. And it was very funny because they have the wall, they build a big, big museum, but they have no collection, no nothing inside the museum. So it was interesting to question why, and also I think why it's important, and to why now some country in Africa wants to build museum, and also to understand the importance to have a own piece of art, to collect it, to also to archiving. And we have this kind of debate in this space during 1 month, because we invite many historians, curators, artists, activists to question what is the future museum. Maybe the colonial classical museum, maybe it's not the future museum. Maybe you must try to rethinking for the African people how to exhibit art today, and not trying to, how do you say, to de refaire, to reproduce the same thing. And also we have another debate also about the future museum, because they have the Louvre, the opening of the Louvre in Dubai, and also in 20 we will have an opening of the Centre Pompidou in Bruxelles, and the Centre Pompidou in Shanghai. And we say that is it the new way, and also the new museum for the future? It's kind of colonization. And we have all this kind of debate, and it was very interesting to question that. Because for me, I think that at the end of the project, and also at the end of this, when we finish to do this publication, and we continue to have the conference in many places, we think that maybe the Centre Pompidou, this kind of museum, for me, I think that maybe it's obsolete, it's a past, and because I was very impressed when Nathalie spoke about the car, and when she spoke about the museum in the car and how to travel with the collection in many places. Maybe it could be one solution, and also to what kind of new museum for tomorrow or today, you know. And I know that people working in the periphery, for me now, it's people who are more, how do you say, creative. It's people who rethinking really the new way to show the other, and also the new way to produce artistic practice, to produce also a new discourse. And we spoke about the center, but I think the center is inside of each people. When you understand that you are the center, I think that you are, how do you say, this kind of, how do you say, debate with the center, which represents the museum, and the collective who produce in the periphery, how do you say, the perception change. And for me, I think it's 20 years that I'm an activist and I'm not really interested about the debate in the institution, because I know that the future in art, it's not in this center called the Classical Museum. And this is very interesting. I invite this free dancer. It's a young dancer who do crumbs. And every day they practice, how do you say, in front of the Centre Pompidou, but they never went inside. And they are very famous. They won a lot of battle. I was very also, you know, how do you say, wants to bring this kind of art inside the museum to try to confront the story of this kind of body in this space. And people was very shocked, because in the museum they have no, how do you say, no sound. We don't have a law to touch piece of art. You must speak, how do you say, charge. And when they started to perform, they perform all days. And her body, they have a whole language with a own sound in this space. And people n'avaient pas l'habitude, en fait, d'être dans un musée où il y a des corps qui produisent des sons qui sont d'une violence par rapport à cet espace qui est censé être sacralisé, qui est censé être sacré, avec des œuvres sacrées. Mais ce qui est intéressant dans cette expérience, c'est comment aussi on confronte le son du musée, qui est ce silence, qui pour moi représente une sonorité, et le son de ces corps qui, quelque part, sont invisibles, mais de par leur sonorité, deviennent visibles. Sorry. What?
Non, en plus, si j'avais un micro, j'aurais pu essayer, non, si vous tenez de...
Ouais.
Yes.
No, translation, did you?
Yes, of course, about these bodies were silent, but the body language was creating like sound in this space, like circular space, which is a museum.
Si tu veux, tu redis, et
non, je parlais en fait des confrontations.
She was speaking about the confrontations.
Et des dualités en fait.
The duality between.
Entre les sonorités qui existent dans l'espace du musée.
The spaces for the museum.
Et les sonorités en fait de ces corps.
The sounds of these bodies.
Qui d'habitude sont des corps invisibles.
Usually are invisible bodies.
Et de par la production en fait de ces sons.
And suddenly the productions of sounds from these bodies
deviennent visibles. Et du coup, les récits deviennent aussi visibles.
Then the tales become visible also.
Parce que le langage, en fait, l'écriture, en fait, corporelle.
Because the writing, the body writing, body narratives.
Et le langage, en fait, sonore qu'ils quelque part produisent.
And the sound language they're producing.
Quand les deux se mélangent.
Il n'y a plus de confrontation en fait. Il y a the coincidence between these two things.
Non.
I
spoke about the performance. You know, the language of the body of the performance and the story of this body who are invisible in this space and the confrontation, the duality between the silence with a kind of sound in this museum, how we can, how do you say, cohabiter? Yes, yes. And if it's possible also. Et aussi, est-ce que ces histoires sonores peuvent, en fait, peuvent cohabiter dans cet espace ou pas?
Can coexist or not in this space?
But at the end of the day, en fait, la conclusion que moi j'en ai... At the end of the day,
yes.
It's impossible to, how do you say, to mix this, the sound of this body and the sound of this space.
The silent sound of this space.
Yes, and I think that this museum had not really to, how do you say, to accept this kind of narrative now.
Thank you very much.